Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today I'm gonna be walking you through the signs, symptoms, and troubleshooting steps for diagnosing a bad transmission control module. Automatic transmissions do all of the shifting for you, and that is thanks to the transmission control module. The transmission control module takes a ton of different data from the wheel speed sensors, the throttle position sensor, the engine load, engine RPMs, and many more sensors and different data points to basically determine when your transmission should shift and what gear you should be in for the speed that you're going. Basically, the transmission control module controls anything that has to do with gear shifting, and therefore, when the transmission control module goes bad, it can lead to a ton of shifting related issues and other transmission problems that can make it difficult for your vehicle to drive properly. So first off, jumping into some of the signs and symptoms that you're going to get when your transmission control module is bad, you'll notice rough shifting or hard shifting. You'll get delayed shifts or oddly timed shifts. You might have a hard time upshifting or a hard time downshifting. You could get stuck in a single gear. Your engine might stall when you're trying to shift, and you might get weird noises or clunking sounds from shifting. And then the last thing is it could put your engine into limp mode. So when we look at a lot of these symptoms, you could have a problem with your valve body, could be an issue with the clutch, the torque converter, or a number of these internal related components that it's very difficult to diagnose until the transmission is out of the vehicle. But the good news here is the transmission control module is an electrical component, which makes it so much easier to fix and replace if it is the problem. And for the most part, it is usually pretty easy to locate as well. Sometimes it's located in the engine bay, sometimes it's under your dashboard, and sometimes it's on the transmission itself. But for the most part, you can actually access and replace a transmission control module without having to drop the transmission down. So if you do have a bad transmission control module, that's a good thing versus you having a hardware issue that sits inside the transmission that's going to require it to be dropped to fix. So the biggest question is, how do we diagnose whether the problem you're having with your transmission is electrical and related to the transmission control module, or if it's hardware related and a more serious internal transmission related problem? So let's go ahead and talk about some of the steps that you'll want to take to diagnose your transmission issues and figure out if it is the transmission control module or something else. The first step is going to be getting an OBD2 reader and reading your engine codes and your transmission codes. Not every OBD2 reader can read transmission codes. Most of the ones that you find on Amazon or eBay for 20 or 30 bucks aren't gonna have the capabilities of reading TCM codes, so you will need to buy one specifically that can handle transmission codes. If you have an OBD reader, check if it does that. If you're buying one, make sure you buy one that can read transmission codes. Otherwise, it's not gonna be very helpful in diagnosing transmission-related problems. There are a lot of sensors and readings that go into the transmission control module and its calculations to determine when to shift. As we think about that, any sensor that could cause a bad reading that gets sent to the TCM could cause an issue with your transmission. If you've got an issue with the wheel speed sensor and that's feeding bad data into the TCM, that can cause your TCM to start shifting erratically because of the bad data that it's getting. And so while you do want to scan for transmission codes, you also want to scan for whatever engine related codes you have, because some of those engine codes could be causing your transmission related issues and could be causing those transmission codes. So it's not necessarily specific to transmission codes. You need to be wary of what other problems you might have. Even if it doesn't sound like it's transmission related, it still could be affecting it. A few common codes that you'll get if your problem is with the transmission control module itself will be P0613, P0614, P0700, and U0101. There are a ton of other transmission codes out there. These are some of the most common ones that would point you in the direction of the transmission control module rather than another transmission related issue. It's also worth noting that the transmission itself has a number of sensors. There's a lot of sensors that are external to the transmission, but there's also a number of internal sensors on the transmission as well. So you can get a transmission code for an electrical related problem with your transmission that isn't specific to the transmission control module because it could be a different transmission related sensor. So step one, read your codes. That's going to be the easiest way to point you in the right direction. But let's say you don't have any codes or you don't want to go through that process quite yet. The second step would be to locate your TCM and inspect it. There will be some wiring with it, and so you want to make sure the wiring isn't chewed through or rotted out or there aren't any faulty connections at the TCM. Step three, a lot of transmission related problems can be caused by being low on transmission fluid or having dirty and old transmission fluid. First of all, make sure you're topped up on transmission fluid. Secondly, make sure your transmission has been flushed and the fluid has been changed at whatever interval it should be changed at. Some vehicles have a lifetime transmission fluid and some of them need to be replaced every 100,000 miles or so. Just make sure you've done that. From there, the fourth step that I would do, which is always a good step for any diagnostic related problem as well, is checking all of your fuses and relays. Look at your owner's manual, see what fuses or relays you might have that could potentially be related to anything transmission wise. And go ahead and check those and replace those if they're bad. And then step five is going to be to unhook your battery and let your car sit for a couple hours or overnight with your battery unhooked. What this does is it causes your transmission control module to completely reset. Your transmission control module can essentially learn things over time. It has what's called adaptations. It can adapt to the conditions of your vehicle and your engine. So sometimes you can just have an issue with one of your transmission adaptations or a weird bug or glitch going on with your transmission control module to where leaving it completely unhooked, giving it no electrical power, and letting it reset itself completely fixes the issue. That is a worthwhile step to try before you start throwing any money at your vehicle in the first place. So that covers it for my diagnostic steps. Just to run through them a little bit more quickly, read your engine codes and your transmission codes, inspect the transmission control module and its wiring, make sure you've got enough transmission fluid and that it's been changed as recently as it should have. Check all of your fuses and relays, and then try resetting your transmission control module by unhooking the battery and leaving it unhooked for a number of hours or overnight. Anyways, guys, that covers it on the transmission control module. Ultimately, it's a little bit difficult to diagnose these problems without reading code, so absolutely start there. You can kind of determine that your transmission problem is internally related if you go through all of the steps on this list. If you don't have any codes, if you've tried resetting your TCM, you've flushed the fluid, it's topped up, you've checked all of your fuses, if you've done all of those things, your transmission's still acting funny, it's probably going to be an internal hardware related problem with your transmission. By going through all of these steps and checking everything that potentially could be electrical, we are now eliminating anything electrical being a problem, and then we can look towards internal transmission components and potential hardware issues and hardware faults. Being able to diagnose whether you have an electrical problem or you have a hardware problem. And all of the things on my diagnostic list will help you determine if you have an electrical problem or not. Anyways, guys, that covers it for my video on the transmission control module. If you have any questions, go ahead and drop a comment below. And if you appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for our future videos.